Hi, this is Anvesh. How are you today? Are you having a great day? If not, make it a great day. Okay? So here we are, Anvesh, and I just wanted to share with you a workflow tip that will really make our workflow snappier, faster, and efficient. So let's go ahead and jump straight in. So we have an image and we have a background layer, one group for the background and one the subject layer. Okay, so by the way, I have used the overlay technique to change the background. If you want to know more about this, check out the video right here. So if I just open the group, have a look. This is the background and I've just added a hue saturation to it to take the saturation away a little bit. Okay, suppose we want to blur this out, blur the background out, really simple. What do? We go to filter, right? Click on filter. Find out where blur is. Okay, this is not blurred. This is not blurred. You already guessed where I'm going with this. Find out where the blur is and then figure out where Gaussian blur is and then just click on it. Now, this is kind of difficult. Choose the values and click OK. This is difficult. Time taking, right? So instead, what you can do, you can go to edit and then choose menus. Okay, now you know, I know that we use Gaussian blur more often than any other blur. So what we can do, we can add a color to it. So here's what we do. So out of all these menus, so we are in the menus, keyboard shortcuts and menus dialog box, and make sure menus is selected, menus tab. And then in the filters, we can choose blur. Okay, there's the blur, and under blur, there is something called Gaussian blur. We can add a color to it to easily locate that. So click on none and choose any color that you want. I'm going to choose red. And also let's add a color to blur itself, the blur menu. So click on this and choose red for it. And there are a couple of things that we don't want. And these eyes control the visibility. If these eye go off, if I click on that, eye goes off, it's not visible. If the eye comes on, it's visible. You could not go more indicative or more symbolic than this. Eye is visible, of course. That is quite a very, how shall I put it? Obvious thing. Okay, so we never use box blur, do we? Okay, so let's go ahead and check it off. If you do, make sure to check it on. Don't turn it off. Just, I'm showing you the process. We never use blur more, or maybe blur, or maybe radial blur, something that I don't personally use. So I'll just turn it off. Shape blur, I don't use that. Okay, now once you're satisfied, you can go ahead and click OK. Now have a look at the filter right now. If you click on filter, very easy to locate that. Very easy. Now very easy to locate Gaussian blur now. Once in a while, once in a year or two, if you want to use something like box blur, you don't have to go to the menus and just reset that or make it visible again. All you have to do, click on this, show all menu items, and it will show you everything, right? And that way you can go ahead and just go to edit, menus, and make everything that's important to you, every adjustment or every time you go ahead and change it from 16-bit to 8-bit, the color mode, then you can color mark almost everything. For example, inside of images, for example, you do something called not under adjustments, you change the mode to RGB CMYK. You can just add a color to it. So selective color, every interesting thing right here, auto color, rotate. Okay, so if you rotate it again and again, you can use these. You get the idea what to do, right? So make sure that we first of all color the ones, color tag the ones which are important. Remove the ones which we seldom use, maybe thrice or four times in a year or so, right? Remove the ones. And we can always click on show all to show all of the effects or all of the filters or all of the menus that are missing that you hid. And that's pretty much it. Hope this video helped you in any possible way. If it did, make sure to give us a like, and also don't forget to subscribe, and not just subscribe, ring the bell so that you, my friend, don't miss anything. I'll see you guys in my next one. Till then, stay tuned and make sure that you keep creating.